Good morning, this is Doug Jackson with submarineboat.com, and today we're going to put our dogs into our submarine. And these have been cast out of aluminum. All the parts are there, but I didn't make the groove big enough in these parts where the bolt goes through, so I'm having to use my lathe to cut that groove again. And see, I got an O-ring in this one now. It's ready to go, and we're going to have to do now the rest of these. And Aiden is helping me polish the shaft of the bolt, right? You're doing a good job. Let me see what you did. Let me look at it. Let me see. Take it out. Let me see. There it is. And see, I'm getting a little bit of the crud off that. Oh, that's looking much better. It's smoother because we had dirt on it. And these don't have to be perfect. They just got to hold a little bit of pressure back with the water. So we're not having to be too accurate here. But the whole trick is to get a bit that can cut on a groove on the inside. And I'll put up a diagram to show how to grind that bit. I got that somewhere. And what it does is it reaches into the part and cuts the groove on the inside. We could cut it into the bolt. That's stainless steel bolts, and they're a lot harder than this aluminum piece of casting here. And so what I got is I got the indicator here to show me how much I travel back and forth on it, so I can make the width of the groove. And then I know on the cross slide how many turns, which is actually two turns, to get it the right depth into to make the groove. And what you want on these, if you can go to Parker Seal, and they got a great PDF file all about how O-rings work and how they're measured and such. And what you want to do is you want to get it so that you compress the O-ring the right amount, which I think is like 20% compression. For what I'm doing, that's working out fine. So you take the measurement of the O-ring and then take 20% off of that, and that's how much you want to make it compress. And it's just then a matter of measure the diameter of the shaft and how big the hole is in the piece, and then how much you figure out how much you got to slide across to get that the tip of this bit into the bottom of that groove. And I've been getting the attention of a lot of trolls lately. And so let me explain on this video that, if you're a professional and know how to do this, wonderful, make your own videos. And I'm an amateur, all right? My goal here is to show people that you don't have to be an expert to get this stuff done. That us amateurs can do it and have fun. So if you're a troll, go fuck yourself, okay? Yeah. Thanks. Okay. Here, do some more. You tell me when you're done, okay? You done?
Yeah.
Is it good?
Yeah.
Is it smooth?
No.
You did a good job. No. Oh yeah, there's all the grit there in it.
Yeah.
Yeah. You ready to do another one?
No.
There's only six. So we go to the width, in a little bit, back. I'm just getting in the ballpark. This is making guys that run lathes for work, for a profession, they're just going nuts. But if you're an amateur, what you need to do is go ahead and make the videos, because it really helps me to see videos that are made by people who don't know everything. Because the guys that know everything, most of them just troll around through the internet looking for places where they can leave nasty comments. And when they do make a video, they often use terminology that they haven't explained yet. So, and they'll criticize you for your tooling that you're using. Oh, you should buy a better lathe. It's like, dumbass, it's my money. You want me to have a better lathe that bad? Buy me a lathe. I'll take it for free. That'd be no problem at all. Do that shit. But, so my point is, if you're an amateur, make your videos, man. Because I like watching them. I like seeing what people come up with that are creative. If I wanted to be a machinist, I would have gone through that boring set of school and I would have set my ass behind one of those machines for 20 years, but I had no intention of doing that. I'd just rather do something and get the job done. And man, I learned that stuff from amateurs, not from the professionals. They only know how to do it when they're spending $20,000. So make your videos, guys. Okay, so here we are in the cabin. These pieces fit right into there,
and they're all custom cut because they're all a little bit different size for where they go. So we're going to silicone that down, put a couple screws to hold it in, and then put the rest of the dog in.
Isn't the hatch going to fall down? Because we have a dog.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have a dog.
That's my dog.
We have a dog, and the dog has a handle. And the handle has a bolt going through it with a spring, and the dog down on the bottom so that we can dog the hatch from the inside. And for emergencies, a diver can come up and put a wrench on this and crank our hatches open from the bottom so he can open the bottom hatches, which is probably the best way to get out of this submarine anyway, because there's two bottom hatches. Anyway, so five more to go, and we got our hatch dogs in. Then we'll hinge the hatches in there and see how they work.